Sunset Gower Studios, and we're here once again with the show. We call it We Love Rare Grooves, where we bring you the magic of the music and the music of the magic. And I'm your host, C. Mose, and I want to thank our listening audience from all over the globe for continuing to support us. And now we're on iHeartRadio, so I call that
Yay!
So thank you very much, UVNRadio.com, for supporting us. That's what you can listen to us tonight on Channel 1. As every week, we bring it to you. But I can't do this without my cast and crew, as I say, every Monday night, starting off with the world-famous DJ DeVoe. What you say, my
brother? What's up, brother? How you doing?
I'm doing wonderful, man. Did we do it?
Man, we got it in Saturday. We got some of the crew here, so I'm looking forward to this show.
We got a lot
all
of
things
the crew
fashion.
Here.
This is going down.
Man, you talking about support? Man, them women are supporting each other,
yeah.
Aren't they?
Oh, yeah.
Beautiful. How it should be.
Fashion icon, East. And then, hey, and then you got my main man over there, DJ Greg. What's going on, DJ Reggie Greg? I was thinking about our boys. So
I know, man. Happy Monday, everyone. Happy Monday.
How you doing, Raz? Happy Monday to you, man.
Yes, sir.
How was your weekend?
Very busy. But we got it in, man. We got it in. We were back and forth to, you know, Palm Springs.
You making that cheddar, huh?
A little bit. Just a little bit. Just that much.
Like my DJs to be working there, man. Keeping it busy. Keeping the name out there. We Love Rare Grooves.
Absolutely.
And also we have joining us tonight, the consultant, Robert. You got to know your soul, baby. The music of a lifetime.
Absolutely. Excited tonight. More than just a fashion icon, we got an American story here.
Yeah.
We got generational stuff we want to talk about. Not only do we have the star, we got the mama of the star and the daughter of the star.
Okay.
We're going to get into that star moment in a bit.
That's
but it's,
true.
I'm excited.
They're like a trilogy. You know
what I'm saying? Yeah, I won't say that.
I mean, I'm just saying the mom has her special. Mm-hmm. And of course, our guest, and then her daughter.
Absolutely. That's what I'm saying. I don't know. That's what I call a generation.
Okay. You didn't make that word up either. And continuing on We Love Rare Grooves, we have the beautiful co host, Miss Shantanee Irie.
Hey.
Hi. How you doing, dear?
I'm wonderful.
How was things in your world? We miss you. Saturday.
Everything's in my world. I know that wasn't my fault, though.
You didn't get the memo?
No, you didn't give me the memo.
I heard
that it was outstanding. I would have loved to have been there.
Well, we would have loved to have you there. And you will be there moving forward. So
yes. How was your weekend?
We always forget
to talk to introduce you and to talk about your weekend.
My weekend was wonderful. Everything went perfect. And, you know, that's what we're going to get into tonight, how the weekend was.
Mm-hmm.
It was beautiful. It was a beautiful weekend, beautiful women. It was legendary here in Los Angeles past weekend. But without further ado, we want to thank our sponsors. As we do every Monday, we can't do it without them. Beverly Boy, Beverly Boy Video Production, where you get your videos. Production from Miami to New York to L.A., K.O. Beverly. And also Wings Limousine, where you
ride like a star.
I'm telling you that. And also, we'll be bringing you the Fly Poet Summer Slam Explosion coming up August 5th.
Mm-hmm.
Music Soul Child.
Tank.
Go on. No, Tank, not Tank. Music Soul Child.
No Tank?
And
no Tank?
It's Music Soul. That's why we're here to get
okay.
Right.
Okay.
And Guamale.
That was a
here.
Quick change.
Things move quickly.
Yeah.
Things move quickly. But without further ado, we got icon tonight.
Okay.
Be all right?
Yeah, you see how I
Icon. You stutter a little bit. You get, you know.
You're going to say yabba dabba do.
I mean, we got someone that you wouldn't believe. I'm going to have to use some numbers here. A model that attained her success in the 60s.
Mm.
Starting out in the 60s.
Bam.
Wow.
And she was one of the first African-American models within the fashion industry to achieve prominent success on the runway and print model.
Okay.
She started her career, of course, Ebony Fashion Fair tour,
yes,
which led her to meet and work with many fashion industry top enterprising people of her era.
Okay.
Diana Verlin, the photographer Irvin Penn, Richard Avedon, and Andy Warhol. Those are names.
Andy.
And became a muse for Salvador Dali. She's made appearances in the fashion model from American Vogue in 1970. Come on.
Beautiful.
In that same year, she appeared on the very first issue of Essence.
The very first?
Very first.
Okay.
And she also appeared on many covers for Vanity Fair, Interview, Harper's, Cosmopolitan. I can name and keep naming them.
Yeah, we could go on.
Keep going
on and on.
All of Condé Nast. Let's talk about that. All of Condé Nast.
And we're going to talk to her about this, but also maybe the pinnacle of career would be the Battle of the Versailles Fashion Show.
Okay.
And I know we're about music, but man, when she talks about this, you're going to be pleasantly surprised. And she was one of the few black models to appear on that legendary fashion show. But today you can find her performing and singing as tribute to Josephine Baker.
Yes.
And she's also an accomplished author with her current best-selling book, Walking the Muses, a memoir. And this will be covering her early life in Harlem and in the fashion industry. So without further ado, we're going to welcome to the Groove Studios royalty itself in the fashion industry, none other than the glamour, the exceptional, the beautiful, and sophisticated Miss Pat Cleveland.
Charming people, thank you for having me here this evening. I'm just so thrilled. Oh my God,
gorgeous.
Again, like you said, we talked to you, we're about the B side of the music, keeping R&B music, soul, and jazz music alive. But it all corresponds with each other. It intertwines music, fashion, it all goes together. So tonight, we're going to let people know. I know you've been on many shows, but tonight we're going to let them know the importance of what it meant to you and your life and what you left to the end. What you're currently still doing.
Well, if that music isn't in your soul, you don't have anything to work with.
Right.
Come on. How long has it been in there?
Right,
let it out.
Every fashion show got music.
That's right. You have jazz playing live and girls moving their derrieres in the right direction. Big thighs and all. It's delicious. When you hear that good music, you just have to get out there and express yourself. What would we be without jazz and R&B and all of those good songs? And those great musicians like UB, Blake, and Sissel, and all those people who came before. I knew them as a child. I sat on your knee. I guess I get some of that DNA. And I think you just move it and groove it and take the fabric along for the ride. That's what I always think.
So what music do you remember playing in your household at an early age?
Had Miles Davis. Mm-hmm. We had the classic. We had, we had Nancy. We had Billie Holiday. We had all those wonderful people like Lionel Hampton, Duke Ellington. Take Five was on all day.
It's still on all day on the wave.
And when you get that spirit behind you, well, something's bound to bloom in your soul.
So when you started out, it was a young age. We're going to touch base a little bit about how it started out for you at a very young age and your family. Because it all comes from the roots, you know.
Let's talk about your mama.
Yeah, let's talk about the Deep South now.
Right.
Talking about Georgia. We're talking about knowing where James Brown came from.
Okay.
We're talking about the fact that my Aunt Sally had this restaurant, and every night James Brown used to say, "Aunt Sally, I'm hungry, give me that food." And my grandmother used to run a sort of like drinks and dance place at her home. When the circus came to town, she would just invite that albino from down in New Orleans to come play that roly piano and scrub that wire washboard, and people would be dancing and having a good time in there.
Did y'all hear how she put the Zydeco in there?
The washboard.
The washboard,
man. Yeah,
served a lot of purpose.
Well, I specifically want to have you talk about your mother.
Lady Bird, it's Lady her birthday Bird, today. Absolutely. She would be 90-something, but she's a Lady Bird is a historic African-American history painter. She lived through the period of the 1920s and 30s and 40s, 50s, 60s, 70s, 80s, 90s, up to 2000, and she painted all of that history. She painted the Renaissance of Harlem. Mm. She's been friends with Billie Holiday, Billy Eckstein, everybody. She knew them all, and she painted portraits of them, and her work will be going in many museums in the future. Beautiful. I curate her art, and she went through the Martin Luther King and the marches and all those things, and so very expressive, very realistic fine arts painter. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. That was impressive.
Now, how did you become connected with fashion?
I think it's because I watched my mom dressing up and going to costume balls. And I think it's because I walked through I made my own clothes. And one day, I took this subway ride. And this lady followed me and discovered me. And before you knew it, my mom had sent some pictures out to Ebony Magazine. And they said, we'd like to meet you, Mrs. Johnson, the visionary entrepreneur of fashion, bringing fashion to America from Paris, said, we have to have you in our show. And at the age of 15, there I was, wearing all the designs from Europe, brought over to America by Mrs. Johnson. Mrs. Johnson and her husband, the publishers of Ebony Magazine, gave me the chance to walk that runway with the jazz musicians playing behind me, and it just took on. We traveled around America 3 months in a Greyhound bus, and we made sure those clothes were shown to everybody that wanted to see them.
That's nice.
And now today we have flair to carry on that history.
That legacy.
Now,
did you guys have live music sometime during the show?
Of course we had Dave. He was our musician. And we went around from city to city, and he hired an extra few musicians, but he always had that cool, expressive accent. As each girl came out, he had a special tune for each one of us. So it was very special to have live music, of course. Yeah. You know, you only had that with the fashion fair.
That's true. Now, the Funk Brothers was like for Motown, and then the Sounds of Philadelphia was behind the scenes for that. What was the band called for the Ebony Fashion Fair? Well, did they give him a name?
No, I think it was just Dave Rivera.
Dave Rivera
was
right?
Just Dave. You can have a one-man band
right. And
sound like a million people when you got the right talent.
Right.
Right? And you just put your fingers and let them go across that ivory, and you've got something gold. You got to have soul for that, though.
There you go.
And you got to have R&B. You got to have a lot of history in you. You have to live it, eat it, breathe it, and let it out. You know,
man, that's
music production.
Thank you for that. That's great, because I had just thought about that. But we're going to continue the show. We're going to talk about some of the things that happened during the Ebony Fashion Fair and as your career continued on. And also, we're going to get up to the book that you have out now, and also what you've been doing from a musical standpoint.
So we
will continue with that. But right now, hey, Pretty Tony. Can you sneak in what we just did this weekend? Remember with the flair and the honor that you got. How did you feel about receiving that honor?
The Avant-Garde Award from Flair. Oh, my God. I was so honored to be with all of these girls. There must have been 150 of us.
Right.
All the girls from all the years from 1958 until the very last show of Ebony. And they showed up in splendid form, as gorgeous as a dream come true. I swear to you, it was like a box of candy. He's coming out on that runway. Everyone is excited. I jumped out of my seat.
I can't think about that.
My award.
He couldn't have described it better himself.
Right.
Box of candy.
So we're going to highlight the young lady that emceed the show. We're going to let the folks know how she thought about this event. She's going to give us
a quick Shirley event. Strawberry here. Ade, why don't you give the family their birthday shout out? Mm-hmm. Happy birthday.
Yeah, happy birthday. We're going to do those. Before we do, I have to say a big, big thank you to all the wonderful folks with Flair, the Fashion Legacy Association for Industry Recognition, the founder, Lady Faye Clerk Mosley, for having me out over the weekend. They had a fantastic show there at the LA Trade Tech College, an evening of Hollywood glamour where they honored the very best in our industry, those that paved the way, and some wonderful people were there. The supermodels, oh my God, these icons, Pat Cleveland, they honored her, Shayla Simpson, icon Richard Roundtree was in the house, Shaft, we loved him. Of course, honoring Linda Stokes, designer of the ward, Kevin Hall was there, Damone Roberts, who lent his services. You know, he is the king of arches. We certainly thank him for everything he did. Lady Frida Payne was there. Marilyn McCoo, I was so excited to see her. Billy Davis Jr., Sherry Payne, Cassandra Calloway there, Audrey Smaltz, the voice of Fashion Fair, when they had that. These, all the alum Fashion Fair models were there, the designers. It was just an absolutely fantastic evening. Thank you so much for having me. I enjoyed myself. Big thank you to Bernard Jacobs, who styled me, who was my everything over the weekend. You can go to our Instagram and Facebook and check out all the pictures at Radio Free KGLH and at Ade Lamar, A-D-A-I-L-A-M-A-R. So many other folks there that we could not get in the list today to name that put me together. Just thank you to all of them. Happy birthday.
What a wonderful recap here by Ade Lamar.
Hey.
From, see, we don't have a problem with another station. See, we can do that right here. Right? We can do that then.
Yeah.
So we're going to go ahead and start the show out with some musical selections of some of your favorites. And we're going to start off with Josephine Baker. And when we come back, we're going to discuss some of the music here with our consultant and yourself, Ms. Pat Cleveland. It is an honor to have you in the Groove Studios tonight. So let's get on with some music as we do here on We Love Rare Grooves.
Cloudy day for me. Since good luck came knocking at my door, skies are gray, but they're not gray anymore. Blue sky smiling at me. Nothing but blue skies do I see. Blue birds singing a song, nothing but bluebirds all the day long. Never saw the sun shining so bright, never saw things going so right. I noticed that the days are hurrying along, when you're in love, oh how they're gone. Bluebirds, all of them gone, nothing but blue skies all the day long. Going so right, I noticed that the days are hurrying along, when you
morning, honey. Thought we said goodbye last night. I turned and tossed until it seemed you had gone. But here you are with the dawn. Wish I'd forget you, but you're here to stay. It seems I met you when my love went away. Now every day I stop by saying to you, good morning, honey, what's new? Stop haunting me now. Chase you no how. Just leave me alone. I've got those Monday blues, straight through Sunday blues. Good morning, honey. Here we go again. Good morning. Good morning, honey, you're the one who knew me when. Might as well get used to you hanging around. Good morning, honey, sit down. Just leave me alone. I've got those Monday blues, straight through Sunday blues. Good morning, heartache, here we go again. Good morning, heartache, you're the one who knew me. Might as well get used to you hanging around. Good morning, heartache. Sit
without means, do it. People
People say in Boston, even beans do it. Let's do it. Let's fall in love. Romantic sponges, they say, do it. Oysters down in Oyster Bay. Even lazy jellyfish do it. Let's do it. Let's fall in love. Electric eels, I might add, do it. Though it shocks him, I know. If Shad do it, way to bring me Shad and Row in shallow shows. English souls do it, goldfish in the privacy of bowls do it.
That girl right there on that interlude, isn't it? Is that Hodges on that?
Hodges, James, yeah.
Oh,
Smith.
Man, you brought that back for us. Oh, man. I just had to let that ride for a minute. But we're back here on We Luvv Red Grooves, coming to you from the studios of Hollywood, California, here on the Sunset Gower. Lot Studios on UBNRadioTV.com. Check us out right now, live on Channel 1 and also live on Facebook, as we have the lovely, iconic Miss Pat Cleveland.
Hey, Pat Cleveland. Although she's not from Cleveland, we still going to accept it.
Yeah,
of course we will. Nobody care about Cleveland.
Right. Okay. Wanted to make her my homegirl. Okay. Just wanted to make her my home girl.
She's from New York. That's why Greg missed it tonight, because she's from New York. So we start off there. How did you feel how we started off with Josephine Baker?
I think it's just nourishing for us to know that woman. She gave us glamour. I mean, she's the showgirl of showgirls. Let's give her the shout out, because she needs to be remembered for all she brought to the game. She traveled the world in furs and satins and silks and had kings wrapped around her finger just because she sang so beautifully.
Man, that's great that you brought that up, because that's part of the show, is keeping this music alive. And that song was released in what, Robert? What year was it?
1927. And it's so interesting, even today, that what we really want to do is just talk about the iconic progressions of great female singers. From really the cover from your mom's time period to your daughter's time period.
That's so, right.
And everybody in between. That's what the direction is today.
In between.
With the lovely Billie Holiday and Ella Fitzgerald, all icons in there, on their own.
The original divas.
There you go.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
So when we introduced you, we were talking about some of the interesting things that you started off being the first of. So you were actually first and many, many things. But tell us how that meant to you, being the first of being in this industry.
Well, it's kind of like, you know, if you were a surfer and you saw the wave come in, and there's something intuitive about, you know, I think it's more about having the torch passed down to me through, you know, the intelligence of the people around me. It's not just like me. It's just like maybe they saw something, or maybe I was useful in that moment to illustrate something. You know, I worked with illustrators, painters, designers, and maybe I just came along with that sort of thing that they needed at the moment. So it's not just by yourself that you're first. You start out with a lot of people are having their first. We were all young and just starting to illustrate, to draw, to sew, to sing. We had music that we needed to listen to. And being the first is just every decade you're a first. And I just felt like, yeah, I'm young. These are my friends. We're going to party together and have a good time. And that's what it's all about, the joy of being together. And that's the first thing I looked at as being the first, is are we having a good time doing the things we love to do creatively? And I was there with the designers, and they dressed me, and I loved it. So that was a first for me, being loved in that way.
Oh, yeah.
Now, tell us something about what you would feel was something special, or that what Mrs. Johnson really meant to you and the Johnson's family with Ebony.
Well, I grew up with Ebony magazine, like the Bible of our family, and Jet magazine, and it was just the society. You know, we brought all of these people to the fore by seeing them in the magazines and talking about the things they achieved. And, you know, in our society, the doctors, the lawyers, the judges, the beautiful girls, the designers, and the photographers, you know, all in that magazine. And Mrs. Johnson, the visionary, she meant so much because she brought fashion to us ladies. She said, this is the good stuff. This is the fashion. These are the fabrics. These are the people. So that we could know how to be the best. She brought out the best in us. She taught us to be ladies. She made sure that when we did that fashion fair, we represented the highest quality of what a lady could be dressed up.
Absolutely. Beautiful.
That's beautifully stated, because it meant so much to us at that time, you know. Absolutely. Seeing those positive images.
Yeah. Absolutely.
One other thing I wanted to think about is, talk to us about how your art and background helped enhance your modeling, because I don't know if everyone knows that you were in a design school, and mm-hmm. your background is that before yeah. you became that fashion runner.
Well, I grew up next to an easel, my mother being a painter, and she always said, well, one day I drank this liquid that had some sort of color in it. I thought it was Kool-Aid, and it was actually the watercolor paint. And she said, don't worry. You know, to be an artist, it's in your blood now.
Literally.
So I thought it was in my blood to be an artist, and I went out and tried to pursue, because I wanted to dress up and I wanted to look good. So I had to make my own clothes in the beginning because they were so expensive. So I would look in the magazines or try to get an idea and make little drawings. And then somehow that all turned into going to art school, where I learned how to put the things together the way you should, you know, a professional. And then when I was very young, because of that artistic mother of mine who right. dressed up and went to costume balls, I mean, our living room looked like confetti of boa. There was sparkle everywhere, and so she always won these costume balls, and I always thought, is this real life? And yes, it was the bohemian way to live artistically. So it got into me. I studied art, and then I became a young designer. At the age of 15, I had a collection of my clothes at this club called Cheetah. It was this was an amazing club.
Yeah. The Cheetah Club.
Yeah, when you walked in, you saw my clothes hanging there in that boutique. And I made those patent leather skirts with boa feathers. You know, I had to look a little bit like a peacock when I went out. So I dressed up everybody, and I got known for that. And that's how I started really in fashion.
So I'm not, my mind it went to the Cheetah Club in Atlanta. And that's
yeah. Yeah. We know exactly where your mind.
I don't know, but this was a big club in New York. You know, it was like the biggest club, and everybody did line dancing or Latin dancing. Frankie Crocker was there, and a whole bunch of wonderful people. And so it was, you know, they had the weekends for teenagers, which I went to with Sugar Ray Robinson's son, and we used to go and hang out with Frankie Crocker and dance, and you know, and so I kind of got noticed there, and then that went on to the next club, and then, you know, just sort of, then I started singing a little bit, this girl's in love with you, that kind of stuff, you know, soft singing in the clubs, and well, it just went from one thing to the other, and then back to fashion, because that's what gets you out of the house, dressing up, you know, so.
So what is your favorite decade of fashion?
Right now?
No, just in your whole entire life, yeah.
I think just like when you're just starting out and you don't know what's what and you're just awed about everything. I think coming out of the late 60s into the early 70s, you know, when the music was changing from that all that love, and we had pure R&B. I mean, there was nothing better than that. You know, those love songs and Up Against the Wall.
Into the right show, didn't you?
Be careful. That was so innocent compared. But, you know, and the music changed. And then we had that 70s, you know, and it started to go, that soul music, you know. And then when James Brown hit the floor, we were ready to dance. You can't keep us from, you can't sit down anymore. You got to get up. And then those disco balls hit the ceiling. And the lights started flashing. And people put violins in the back of the R&B. And then before you know it, we had Barry White, and we had, oh my right God, Otis Redding, and everything. And I'm rushing ahead because it's such a rush to think about how this music gave us so much energy. You know, in the fashion world, I think people made clothes like Stephen Burroughs. He made clothes for the fashions of the music so that you can go out and dance with those matte jersey dresses on and not get overheated, you know. Fabric for dancing, you know, and that's the way you got to think. Movement, moving forward, what do people need? The music dedicates, it tells you what you need.
Well, that's a whole mountain of information.
No, well, that's well stated in the way she went into the music, how it transitioned into the music of the love music, remember at that time, and then it went into
Up Against the Wall.
First,
you know all about that.
Temptation, Stylistics.
And then James Brown transforming it with the dance music, like you said, getting out there and dancing. So, man, this is what we do here on We Love Rare Grooves. We give you the musical history. You know, we educate you on this show.
There it is.
So stay tuned every week, and we have the lovely Miss Pat Cleveland here spitting some science on us tonight, as they say.
She's getting ready to spit some voices next.
Yeah, so. That's what I'm talking about. We got some of her music.
That's what I'm talking about.
All right.
But before that, let's give our some love to, we ready for our boys over there at Beverly Boy. Beverly Boy.
My name's Dave Patterson. I'm a Seattle area videographer. I've been working with Beverly Boy Productions for over 2 years, and I can say they are great to work with. They've always provided me with the information I need so that when I show up on set, I can shoot exactly what's necessary to tell the story the client is trying to tell. Call sheets that include the who, what, why, where, when of the video shoot, production notes, gear requirements, crew requirements, load-in time, all that. Makes my job a lot easier, and ultimately it produces the results that the client's going to be happy with. This is what a professional company like Beverly Boy Productions does, and also it's one of the reasons why I really enjoy working with them. It's a bit of a family vibe. They're very low-key, low-pressure, but they're very professional at the same time, and they get the results, and that's ultimately what matters most. I'm proud to be a shooter for Beverly Boy Productions, and if you're looking for a company to produce your next video production, by all means, give them a call. They can handle any sort of scale project from a single person interview to a large production with multiple cameras and large crews. You won't be disappointed with the results. Give them a call.
Be afraid to give them a call at Beverly Boys Production. And what's that big number there? 1-800-385-1243. Man, that boy got it.
Damn, he got it today.
1-800-512-1243. Give Kale and his brother that their team a call and get you a video production today. They took care of it Saturday night.
Yeah.
So we're looking forward to see that highlight video, as we do here on We Love Red Grooves, here on Channel 1 on UBNRadio.com. And if you want to give us a call, the phone number is 323-524-2599. Oh, watch out now. It's going to be trouble.
Absolutely.
Trouble. And we're going to continue the show with...
Well, first, we forgot. We want to send out a wonderful congratulations to our producer extraordinaire, yeah, Mr. Greg New York Sneed, who tied the knot this weekend in Mexico.
Mexico.
We don't know who the unfortunate lady is, but we love her. And oh, you were going to save that for the end?
And show a picture, but you can do it again at the
end. Oh, well, you can do it again at the end.
No, you can do it again at the end.
You can do it again at the end.
Okay.
You can do it again at the end.
Well, yes. I just wanted to say congratulations to Greg Sneedums.
We can do it twice.
Sneedums. Yes.
Okay.
Oh, you can do it again at the end.
I'll do it again.
Okay, okay, I'll do it again.
We'll DeVoe will always do it again.
Okay. You see how we are? It's like being at the barber salon.
Yeah. Well, yeah, the barber. I'm the one female barber.
Right. Right, from the silver shop, so you're right. Continuing on here on We Love Red Grooves, our next song. Won't you introduce what we have coming up next?
Well, I had a wonderful experience working with Maurice Lynch, and he's a gospel singer who travels the world to Russia and spreads the word of the good feeling. And he wrote this song for me to perform at my book party in New York that I had at the Jean Hotel.
Okay.
And the song is a tribute to Josephine Baker, and it's called Tonight Josephine. And there's two versions. There's the dance version and there's the slower version with my voice just singing a song. And so here we go. Thank you.
Swing with show's theme tonight.
You look so good, good, good tonight. Josephine.
As they say in Paris, c'est si bon, how good it is.
You look so good, good, good tonight. Just shake your thing.
Maybe I'll shake a little more, shall we? But don't beg. Nights. I was a coffee and Paris was the cream. Ladies, Chanel told me a girl should be classy and fabulous. Always reach for the stars in your land and your dreams. Tonight I belong to you and I know you belong to me.
Then go back, just do your thing, you're the jazz.
Ooh.
Asia, Paris, Queen.
Please take my heart and always remember, I make that jazz hot.
Jazz is Paris.
Because I'm Queen Josephine.
Here comes the sun, little darling. Here comes the sun, I say, it's all right. It's all right. Here comes the sun, little darling. Here comes the sun, I say, it's all right. Little darling, it feels like years since you've been here. Here comes the sun, little darling. Here comes the sun, I say. The smiles are returning to the faces now. Little darling, it seems like years since you've been here. Little darling, it's been a long, cold, lonely winter. Little darling, feels like years since you've been here. I'm so glad to see it, I see it. Now.
Thank you.
Hit it, Shantanee.
Yeah.
Hit it, Shantanee.
Hit it,
Shantanee. Shantanee's an alto for a reason.
Hit it. We're back here live.
Are we back?
We're back here live in the studio for UBNRadioTV.com channel 1. That's right, UBNRadio.com.
That's when the synthesizer was born.
Channel 1, yeah. Probably by our boy, Dexter Wanzel.
He probably wrote this too.
On the Fender Rhodes. No, he didn't write it.
Oh, he didn't write it?
No. Arif Mardin produced this.
Oh, excuse us. That's why we have the consultant.
Consultant.
In case we didn't know.
In case you know, now you know.
Now you know.
Who's on the band? Who's the band?
Pookie Johnson.
Pookie
was on.
Pookie him.
Pookie was on the bass.
Pookie him.
Absolutely.
Pookie in a lot of groups, man.
He's the default player.
Who played the piccolo?
Supreme. There was this guy called Supreme Gitalo.
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 Yeah.
That's all
right. As we continue on, we love Rare Grooves. We started off. Everyone knows we have the beautiful and talented and iconic Miss Pat Cleveland, and
she's gorgeous.
Cleveland, not from Cleveland.
But not from Cleveland. But she's gorgeous. From
Cleveland. Tell us about the development of that song, Pat. Talk a little bit
with
about
Josephine.
It. Yeah, your song.
My song is just like these guys came out of heaven. I was just sitting home thinking, I want to entertain some people. And this guy, Maurice Lynch, called and he said, you know, my sister loves you. And she said, if anybody's going to sing my Josephine song, it's going to be you. So he said, can I come over? And I said, yes.
Uh-oh.
Hey, hey, hey.
Uh-oh. Yeah. Uh-oh. And that brings us to this.
I said, yes.
Yes.
Please come over and give me that sound. I need to sing that song. Because I love her so much. You know, and the history is that my great aunt was Josephine Baker's Sunday school teacher.
Get out of here.
No, and it was a little shanty town.
Knocked down the front door.
And St. Louis, and my great auntie, she said to Josephine, you gotta get out of town. Go with that. She taught her how to play the piano and encouraged her to sing, and then she went with Shuffle Along. And that's how she got out of here.
Wow.
You know?
Wow.
So now we know the importance of you doing that. Josephine. It's a great song. Sound great.
Thank you.
It has a don't mean a thing if it ain't got that swing kind of sound.
And then we played Nina Simone, Here Comes the Sun. But it's a reason that we played that, because I've been looking at your book, Walking with the Muse. So give us a little bit of backstory with you and Miss Nina.
Well, you know how girls like to sing, and I was in Paris with some of my 7th Avenue Ebony Fashion Fair walking girls, and we were standing in the corner. It was like 2 in the morning. We just like finished the shows and standing on one of those lampposts and Rue Saint-Germain in front of the floor, and me and Billy Blair, we were like harmonizing. You know how people used to do like in the 50s, standing da-da-da, standing on a corner singing some song. Well, we were standing there singing, and this taxi pulls up. We were at the taxi stand. We were singing. This lady, she pulls up. She comes and looks out the window at us. She said, girls, you're singing. You better get in the cab with me because I want you to be my backup singers. Mm. And I thought, who is this lady? My girlfriend looked at her, and it was Nina Simone.
Wow.
Miss Nina Simone asked us to sing with her. So we jumped in the cab, and she had on that white fur coat in the middle of summer, and we said, something's going on. Something is going on here. Let's go, girl. She said, I'm so hungry. Can you take me to have something to eat? And there was only one place, La Coupole. And she had that lobster. And before you knew it, oh my God, she let me set her up with some friends of mine, and she was performing. And there in Paris were some friends of mine with the Palace Club, which was the hottest place for fashion. And everybody fell in love with her again, set her up in an apartment. And it's a story, you know, she has her story, but some things are just so splendid and some things are so private. but we admire Miss Nina Simone.
Yeah.
We love her.
We do here on We Love Rare Grooves. What's going
now,
on?
Now, in your book, Walking with the Muses, which I love the cover.
Thank you.
You have in chapter 13, you have a picture backstage in Las Vegas in 1966.
Well, what's a girl to do?
Acting grown up with Bill Cosby.
Well,
and a few models, Diane, Irma, and Gertrude. So tell us about how you found yourself in Las Vegas with
That Ebony Fashion Fair took everywhere, fabulous. And we had a few days off and we landed in Las Vegas. And, you know, I was chaperoned by my mom. But that night, it was a glamour night. I had a silver coat and a silver dress and some silver boots that I wore. And I was bound to wear somewhere.
The boots, too.
And the silver jacket.
And then Red Fox came backstage and he said, "Girls, you want to go out and do some gambling with us?" And somehow he said, "You're coming along as my lucky girl." And Bill Cosby was there. So Red Fox, Bill Cosby, and a couple of us girls went into the casino and started gambling. And Red Fox said, "Girl, you come over here. You're going to be my lucky number. You just blowing these dice." He had me blowing on those dice and winning money.
Did he give you a cut?
Huh? No. He just kept gambling away and giving up money to us to play with.
And so your mother was your chaperone?
Oh, she let me go that night. I don't know. I just was out there. And he kept telling those grown-up jokes, and I think I probably was understanding them. I thought he was great, you know, and Bill Cosby, and then that Ebony Fashion Fair. We later went to Bill Cosby's home and met his kids and everything, and it was just sort of big time, big time.
Now, what year was this picture?
I just want to reiterate, that's at least it's a positive Bill story. And see, absolutely.
So thank you so much. A lot of positive Bill stories.
Well, we know that, but just lately.
Wait a minute, hold on. Can I put a caveat to it? She was gambling in Vegas in 16.
And her mother was her chaperone.
Right.
Mama was getting paid off too, so I get
all right. So what year was this?
That was on the cover of the London Times Sunday News.
And
that was
picture.
Taken by a female photographer. She was from Holland. Mm-hmm. And that was sort of like, you know, I call that my bumblebee picture. Because I like to do strange poses, walking on my fingers and stuff like that. But that was in 71, 72. Mm-hmm.
And she has
like
an editorial at the end or a comment for Andre Leon Talley. For those people that don't know, let me put it this side so you can see. For those people don't know, he is a huge Vogue fashion contributor and editor. He works with Anna Wintour for those fashion gurus, so he gave her.
What was his name again?
His name is Andre Leon Talley.
He's tall.
And he is the king of fashion in
6 foot seven.
Yes. Yes.
Very
elegant.
Very, very, very elegant.
Yeah. So we got some. You want to do Chantilly in 60 seconds?
Sure. Can I get some fun. Jeopardy music? Really?
Can we get some? We're going to have some fun here. We're going to do... You ready for these questions in 60 seconds
or
less?
No, they're not on your paper. These are going to be 60 random questions, and I'm going to ask you, and you're going to have to answer them in 60 seconds or less.
Okay, let's get my watch out here.
Oh, we're going to give you the clock. We're going to give you a time.
You got a clock?
Yeah,
okay.
We got a...
Tell me when you're starting.
Okay. Your first job?
Was with the Ebony Fashion Fair, other than being a dog walker and a babysitter.
Your favorite song to perform?
Oh my God, I like to sing Tonight Josephine.
Name a lover gave you?
A lover gave me She's So Cold.
Oh! Greatest piece of advice?
Always go away 7 times with the person you love to see if they're right for you.
Oh, I got to go away a couple more times, I guess. I was born in 1984. What were you doing then?
I was having a baby. My son was born. I was getting married to my beautiful husband, Paul von Ravenstein in Holland.
Paul's in the studio with the wooden shoes and everything.
Yeah.
If you could record or produce an album for a celebrity that is deceased, who would it be?
Oh my gosh, in heaven, who would it be? Can I have them all? I mean, I would like to do some Duke Ellington.
Yes.
Okay, that's good. That's one. And if you hadn't made a career in fashion, what would you be doing instead?
I suppose I would be a painter or... I would be singing. Come on.
Okay. That's 60 seconds.
There you go. Great job.
That's it.
So continue here on We Love Rare Grooves. Give us a call at 323-524-2599. Thank you for that 60 seconds.
She said the name a lover gave her is She's Cold. I've never heard that one.
She's cold.
Which is short for cold-blooded.
Cold-blooded.
No, it just means I need warming up. I need some... You wear those little skimpy dresses. You need some warmth. Oh, so cold.
Big Daddy Paul made it happen. All
yes,
right.
He did.
Hey, so we got upcoming. Let's give some love out to upcoming.
So our 7th annual Fly Poets Summer Classic is going to be at the Ford Theater in Hollywood. It is going to be hosted by the Fly Poets Spoken Word and Music Showcase. And I believe it's Emerald Green, LA's biggest, baddest all-star spoken word, music, and art explosion. Prepared to be severely entertained. Fly Poet is a highly curated all-star lineup of only the hardest-hitting spoken word artists. Saturday, August 5th, 2017, the lineup is 12-time Grammy-nominated artist Music Soul Child, queen of electric R&B Soul Guapole, international slam champion The Queen Sheba, and Guapole will be our guest next week. World Poetry Slam champion Rudy Francisco, poetry star Emerald Green, as seen on HBO TV One, Viceland, and more. Poetry Slam champion Luis Concepcion. I can never say that name.
I know,
right.
That's why I pointed to it.
And, or is it confliction?
It might be, yeah. And comedian London Brown is seen on HBO Ballers. So this is
There's
the 7th.
Tickets.
Oh, you can get your tickets at flypoet.com/summerclassic. Get your tickets now. Summer Classic has sold out in advance 6 years in a row. Beautiful open-air amphitheater and the option to unleash your inner foodie and bring your own picnic. You can bring your own wine and beer as well. Or buy food on-site and engage in one of the most culturally significant art forms around. So visit flypoet.com/summerclassic.
And I highly recommend it. I've been engineering for them for the last 7 years. He does a smaller show in Inglewood, so... Heavy hitting every. I mean,
John,
every
my man, John.
John, yeah, John puts on a hell of
great
a show,
show man. I remember that time we did the whole show for the National Sales Network. Yeah. We dropped it in, member, for one of our events. So I appreciated John for supporting us as we support you. Get your tickets today; they're gonna sell out fast. And next week, Miss Guapole will be here live in studio to talk about her upcoming.
We are so excited!
Excited! Yeah, because next Monday is the day for her, and getting excited for the 7th annual Fly Poet Summer Classic. Okay. So as we continue here on We Love Rare Grooves, I say,
where do we get? Sorry to cut you off, but where do we get this book?
Oh, I'm going to be doing a book signing at Barnes & Noble at the Grove tomorrow, 7 p.m. Be there. Come and see
square.
Me.
Or be square.
From 7 to what? From 7 to what?
Seven till nine, or till when the line is finished.
Okay.
Right. So here's the book.
Get to the Grove tomorrow, 7 p.m. So Mrs. Pat Cleveland will be signing books.
Sign your book.
So, the way it looks, gang, we might as well hit the dusty because we might as well go into it. Yeah. And Robert will take care of the dusty that night because this one is kind of touching me, man. You know,
Robert, you have to explain the dusty to our guests.
The dusty is the fact that the song is so old, it was so deep in the crate that you had to blow the dust off of the dusty. And so it's
so much dust.
Yeah. And so when the old people call it old, it's really old. Okay.
Really old.
Dusty is okay.
Dust.
But even that, tonight we want to honor, as we always pay reverence to the folks who are the foundational in the music business, we lost one, Bobby Taylor.
Yes.
Bobby Taylor and the Vancouvers.
Yes, huge.
Right.
Bobby Taylor, you know, as a marketing person, there's a person that people said discovered a person.
Right.
Yeah.
And the person who discovered him. So the Jackson 5 were presented to the world as being discovered by Diana Ross. But the reality
that's a misnomer. Is that a misnomer?
Absolutely.
Or also known as a lie, but you know.
Right.
Or
that's a nice way of saying lie.
Alternative fact.
Yes.
Go ahead.
But anyways, Bobby Taylor discovered them in Chicago.
That's right.
And I always think about it. He was the one who brought him to Berry Gordy.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And then he had some pretty significant songs. And one of the ones we're going to play tonight is shows you talking about how sociologically things have changed. This song is called Does Your Mama Know About Me?
Does
it?
Which is a not-so-subtle approach to racial disharmony.
Right.
Mm. Right. because. So we're gonna do 2 minutes of that and then 2 minutes. Yeah.
Maybe I shouldn't worry, but I've been through this before.
So that was the Dusty of Week, brought to you by Sweet Events, the supporter, Sweet Events, where you get all your marketing and media needs from Sarah, sweetevents.com. So thank you very much for the Dusty of Week, and may Bobby Taylor rest in greatness.
Yes.
As I say, rest in greatness, man, and we keeping the music alive here, keeping his music alive, and keeping his story straight.
As you should.
As we do here on We Love Red Groove. So, man, it was a great weekend for the Flair organization and the former Ebony Fashion Fair models, designers, hairdressers, makeup, even a guy that drove the bus.
Yeah.
You know, whoever had anything to do with it,
makeup,
selling t-shirts outside, you know, all of them. And It was a great event. My wife put it on with the entire team, Audrey Smaltz, the whole entire team, Lanice, just named a few. Renee turned it out, her and Rona, and also Shayla Simpson was honored. And then we had Pamela Fernandez is joining us in the studio now. This is my girl right here.
Yes, she
took care of the show, Pamela. You was one of the longest running models also, right?
Longest running female model, and also on your wife's tour, and with Karen and Denise, and we just all stayed in touch with each other. So friends, family. I was the first singer, sang all through the 80s and 90s, the first production for comedy. We did a lot of comedy.
So you were singing and doing comedy.
I was doing it all, just like my girl.
Right,
right,
okay.
Here, Pat.
We're twins.
And let you all know, I have Pamela here tonight because Pam was very instrumental in getting us Def Jeff. She called up that night, and she was like, I'm singing. I got EDs. I got songs. I need to come on. So
yeah,
I promised her.
My brother.
So I promised her if she ever came in town, I would go ahead and share some of her music to the world. We're in over 50 countries, and they get ready to hear some music from Pam Hernandez tonight. I'm going to let you elaborate a little bit on. Is this your forthcoming CD, or it's already out?
It's already done, and it's, I know you know my last name, but it is Fernandez.
I mean Fernandez.
You didn't mean to mess it up.
Oh, no, I did. I was reading somebody, whoever did this, put Hernandez on it. Right, whoever did that.
Fernandez.
Right, that's I'm reading.
You mess up my name all the time. Don't worry about it.
But it says it right here. What does that say?
It does say Hernandez.
Okay, but it's Fernandez.
Yes.
Fernandez.
Somebody. Right, I know your name.
He knows in his heart.
I'm just reading. You should be glad I can read.
That's what I'm grateful
for. Does your mama know about me that I can read?
Whoever typed it must be, instead of doing that, they did the H instead of the F, you know.
Yes.
Let's see. I know.
Whoever typed it up.
Yeah.
Robert.
Robert, I ain't taking this.
As we continue on We Love Red Groove, I digress. So, Miss Fernandez.
Yes, indeed, Clifton. After I left the tour, the 15 years, 13 years that I was there, I always wanted to continue to sing. I wasn't sure what I wanted to do, but I said, wait, I got this singing thing going for me. Maybe I should just continue that. So I did, and I sing professionally in Chicago now with a couple of bands, with this CD with my jazz band, Thomas Gunther, my producer from Germany, and myself have worked together many years. And what we did with this CD, some originals as well, but the cover songs, and one of them, Wonderful World, which I can't wait for you guys to hear.
Okay.
Yeah.
Is we kind of just ripped these songs to shreds. They're not done at all in the same typical fashion that's
so like. This is Louis Armstrong.
Wonderful World.
Okay, that's what she said. She's getting.
Myself. tell you other things that I see. Hurting, people crying, people killing, people trying hard. That's what I see. That's what I see. Ba-da-da-da-da-ba-da-da.
night. The morning heartache, thought we said goodbye last night. I tossed and turned until it seemed you had gone. But here you are with the dawn. Wish I'd forget you, but you're here to stay. It seems I met you when my by saying to you, good morning, heartache, what's new?
Morning, heart. Good morning, heartache. Boy, I tell you, that boy, that
classic.
When I seen Lady Sings the Blues, I seen it live. You know that, right? I seen the original movie. I didn't see the remake.
No,
there is no remake.
I'm saying, well, I seen the original movie.
You seen when it came out? You mean?
Yes. Yeah. The first week.
I've seen the same movie you saw.
No, you didn't.
I just didn't see it at the same time you did.
She wasn't thought, your mama wasn't thinking about murder during that time.
Yeah,
exactly.
Murder had come and gone by the time that happened.
No.
Yes, he had.
No.
All right. If y'all get through your heads that murder's not my father, then it'll make more sense to you. Murder came and went in the 60s. He came and he left.
We need to have something up because we keep talking about murder.
I don't know how talk to him.
You're biological.
Nice man.
No, I'm saying you're
not my biological.
I'm saying biological might be getting upset.
All right.
Yeah.
No, he doesn't care.
As we continue the show, we love Rare Grooves. We want to welcome our listening audience all over the globe for joining us for this great, great history lesson of music and fashion. With the iconic, lovely, legendary Miss Pat Cleveland. Thank you so much for being here tonight on the Groove Studios.
Good.
You make me want to just go ahead and get my voice like Quiet Storm, you know.
Watch out now.
Lullabies.
So we came in and I gave Pam Fernandez some love. Hey, team, did she put a twist on her?
Yeah, she put a twist on her.
Huh?
Yeah.
Louis would be proud.
Very
right.
Of course, he wouldn't know that it was his song.
But he loved you.
Somebody had to tell him that's your song.
Thank you. You did a great job of flipping it.
You might have to call up Big Red and see what you want to do. Come to LA and see what we can do. You planning on calling Big Red?
Yep.
You know his office hours?
I do.
Okay.
As long as you know.
She says she know the big boss. She know big boss name.
It don't matter what the hours
are.
She
called the boss.
She gonna go right past him, way over his head.
So Miss Pat Cleveland, we hate to close it out because I mean the book itself.
Yes.
I still had about 10 questions I could ask tonight.
That's a heavy book.
That's not.
It's thick.
Right.
So you guys go to Barnes & Noble's tomorrow, 7 p.m. Tomorrow's the 25th, right? July 25th, Tuesday.
Yeah. At the Grove.
Pat Cleveland, Barnes & Noble's. Barnes & Noble's. She will be there signing autographs and sharing, I'm sure,
this is a
tons
book
of stories.
You want to have in your collection.
Please come over.
And does it have some juicy details in this book?
I think there's enough juice to make it fresh.
Oh, okay.
Is there an audio version of that book?
Do you have an audio version?
That'll be coming up soon.
Soon?
Yeah. Okay, good. Good. I can ride along.
Reggie wants to listen to your voice while he listens to the book.
Exactly. Can you see her listening?
Hey.
This is Pat Cleveland and promptly at 8 in the morning.
No, we don't want your voice, man. No.
He killed the mood.
Take it away. Yes, did you have anything left, Robert? You good?
Absolutely not. All right, just excited about this time period and just continued success to you, man.
Thank you. I appreciate that. Thank you.
So we ask all of our guests in closing, before we ask you how do we keep in touch with you, what are your top 5 entertainers, living or deceased?
Okay, let's go back. We're going to have Charlie Chaplin at the beginning there.
Mm-hmm.
And then we have, of course, Josephine Baker and Mantan Moreland from Charlie Chan.
Yeah.
I loved him as a little girl. I sit on his knee and he used to joke. Oh, he was kind. And then, of course, I love Michael Jackson, whom I did The Wiz with. And also Miss Diana Ross, whom I did Mahogany with. So I love them so much. They're part of me now.
So how do we keep in touch? Go ahead.
Diana Ross?
Yes.
And Mahogany, y'all hung out?
Yes. I told her how to... I was asked to give her walking lessons for the model segment.
that fashion show?
Yeah, I was in the opening scene. Yeah. And she made all the costumes and everything.
I remember. I love that
That's how we got
together. Little known history fact.
Yeah.
There you go.
So how do we stay in touch? How do your fans stay in touch with you?
Well, I have an agent. His name is Kyle over at Next, and I'm always at Simon & Schuster. Dawn, she's my publisher. Mm-hmm. So I think, you know, you just call me up at Next Agency with Kyle. Ask for Kyle.
What about
do you have a website?
And my website, I'm Miss Pat Cleveland at gmail.com. So you can get that.
That's your email. She said you can email her.
You can email me.
How about you? What, is it a website, Plat Killer?
Right now, no.
Do you have Facebook?
Yes, I do have Facebook. And so that's the same thing.
Pat Cleveland.
Please come Twitter? On and Twitter? Say hi.
You got MySpace?
Instagram.
You got MySpace?
No, Napster, I have that Facebook.
No one has MySpace anymore. Yeah. He knows that.
I did have it for a while.
Yeah, we all had mine.
I know, for a while, right? I don't ever think I closed mine. I think it's still open.
Neither did I. So I just don't remember the password.
But again, for everyone that graces the Groove Studios, we like to show our appreciation. So you got DJ DeVoe, DJ Reg, Robert, Shantani, and myself. We like to present something. I know you've got many achievements over the years. I'm sure that mantelpiece and wall and glass is filled up with so many awards, but we want to present to you the We Love Rare Grooves Award.
Hey,
is that for me? Oh my God! Yes. I'm going to use this every day.
As you should.
We're going to change
how
the label.
Fabulous this is! I'm so happy. I'm so happy to be here with you guys. Thanks.
Thank you for taking the time out. I know it's been a busy week for you. You were on KTL TV. You got honored this weekend, and you're at Barnes and Noble. Correct? Tomorrow.
Yes, tomorrow.
In the Grove.
In the Grove.
So thank you so much for being here in Los Angeles this week and giving us all this history and knowledge. So thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Keep it bright.
Keep it bright.
Keep it bright.
Keep it bright. Keep it light.
Little shine. Bright little light. Shine.
Keep it bright and light.
Yeah.
Okay. Keep you know how.
Like you.
That was a good one.
She's on a roll today, man. She's on a roll.
Hey, but again, we want to thank our listening audience all over the globe for continuing to join us and supporting us here on We Love Rare Grooves. We want to thank our sponsors, Beverly Boyd Video Productions, also Wings Limousine, where you
ride like a star.
And that's right, get your tickets today for the 7th annual Fly Poet Summer Classic at the Ford Theater. Go to flypoet.com. Tickets is going fast. It's sold out every year, so I'm sure it will sell out this year again with Music Soul Child and next week's guest, Wapale. So here on We Love Red,
what'd you say?
Don't even ask.
Okay.
We don't have that kind of time.
Okay.
Guapale.
I said Guapale. What else you want
to say? You say Chick-fil-A?
Chick-fil-A.
I may say that next week because it all sounds good together.
Okay.
As we continue here, hey, we're on Facebook, our YouTube page.
We're on Twitter and Instagram as well.
Right.
And we're on MySpace?
No MySpace. Absolutely not. And we're on YouTube, so catch all of our show replays on our YouTube channel. Yeah.
So join us. Thank you so much. Join us again at the same groove time, same groove channel here on
We Love Rare Grooves.
I think we're out.
Yeah, exactly.
Pretty Tony, what we looking like.
Yeah.
Let's do this. Johnny.
Peace.
I'm out.